Hey guys, it's Coach Ben. In today's video, let's talk about crossing. Now, when I go watch players play who play outside mid or they're forward, their attacker's looking to get up the line, I want to talk about how you can improve your crossing and how you can get more assist. So the first thing I think is very obvious. When you're dribbling down the sideline, if you don't understand where the keeper is, then you might be playing the ball to the keeper all the time. And I know this is a common problem I see that players have, because as they cross the ball, they're not looking to see who's in the box. They're just so focused on the ball. When they play it, the keeper can just come snatch the ball. So today, I want to explain what you need to do different, and I'm going to show you at the end of the video a drill that you can do on your own with a teammate that's going to help you become better when you cross the ball. This way you get more assists. Okay, so the first thing we need to do is we need to recognize where the keeper's at. So before I take my final touch, as I take it, I need to see where the goalie's at and I need to know where my teammates are. So this way I can pick out my teammates without the keeper coming out and grabbing the ball. And you can play a ball in the air or on the ground. It really just depends on how far you are and where you want to play the ball. Now in this drill, I'm not going to be that far away from the goal. I'm about actually 15 yards. And what I'm gonna do is look to slot the ball back towards the penalty spot. And I like to teach players to do that just because when they come down the line, the natural tendency is when you cross the ball, if my hips are facing this way, is when I cross it, I'm not gonna be able to cross it away from the keeper. It's going to be going towards the keeper there. So what I want to do is I want to hit a ball here. Now my hips are facing towards the penalty spot, and that way my pass, my cross is going away from the keeper towards my attacker who's going to be smashing the ball in the back of the net. So in this drill, we're going to be starting back this way. I'm going to take a few touches down the line. And remember, after I take my final touch, I'm going to have my eyes up. I'm going to look to play a ball. So what you can do is you can set up either a cone or a grid near the penalty spot. And when you play a ball in, your teammate's gonna be maybe 5 to 10 yards beyond that. They're gonna make the run into that space. And as soon as the ball gets in that box, they should be able to finish. So you're leading them into the run. And it all comes down to vision, knowing where your teammates are. And that's why when you do this drill, you could do it different. You could have the box near the penalty spot. You could have it near the back post. You could have it on the front post. But it needs to be away from the keeper because, like I said at the beginning, if I take my cross here and the goalie is standing on their line, they can just come out and grab the ball. It's too easy. I need to play it away from them, make it harder, right? So I need to play that ball into an area where only my teammates are gonna come and win the ball. Thanks for watching today's video. If you enjoyed it, click the thumbs up button and comment below. Now, if you wanna take your game to that next level, I want you to click on the first link in the description below. It's onlinesoccerskills.com/free-training. That's gonna take you to a page. All you have to do is just enter in your email address and I'm gonna personally email you our highest level skills workout. I'm gonna do that right now. So just go to the link in the description, click on that. It's gonna work on your computer or your mobile device. Lastly, hit that big subscribe button below this video. This way you can stay up to date with all of our newest videos. All right, I'll catch you next time.